हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम कविता सिंह फ्रॉम समर्पण ज्ञान स्कूल एंड वी विल कंटिन्यू हियर आवर 8th स्टैंडर्ड साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 6 कंबशन एंड फ्लेम। नाउ हियर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कंबशन। सो यू कैन सी हियर द 3 टाइप्स ऑफ कंबशन। फर्स्ट इज द रैपिड कंबशन, इट इज वेरी फास्ट। एंड स्पॉन्टेनियस कंबशन मीन्स combustion is on its own, and explosion it's produce a large amount of heat, light and sound. Okay, so we will see first one, that is the rapid combustion. Rapid combustion means combustion in which a gas burns quickly, produced heat and light in this process, for example LPG. Second is the spontaneous combustion. You can see here, that is combustion it's on its own. So combustion in which a material burst into flame suddenly without applying heat, example phosphorus, which burst at room temperature. Okay, and another example is a spontaneous combustion of a coal. Coal dust often cause accidentally fire in coal mines. Now third one is when a material bursts suddenly to produce heat, light and sound on the application of heat or pressure, it is called explosion. For example, crackers, when we burn the crackers, it produced heat also, light also and sound also. Now here we will see a flame. Student, when you burn a candle or a matchstick or a LPG stove, can you differentiate the flame color? Yes, you can see here is the yellow color, here is the blue color, right? So a flame produced by the kerosene when you burn in the lamp, okay, when we burn in the lamp, so their color is yellow. You can see here, when we burn the lamp with the kerosene, their color is yellow and it is very smoky. But when we burn the stove, the flame of LPG stove is blue and it is a smokeless. And you can see here these three flames. First one is the kerosene lamp, second one is the candle, and third one is the Bunsen burner. You can see the candle zone flame color is different, here is the different, and third one is the different. Here is the lots of smoke, here is the yellowish color flame, and here is the blue color flame. Okay, so kerosene and wax, kerosene is a liquid fuel and wax is a solid fuel, and both vaporize on heating to burn with a flame. Okay, so matchstick, kerosene lamp and candle produce yellow flame on burning, and it is a blue. Okay, but what is a flame? Do you know about what is a flame? Flame is a hot glowing body on ignited gas which is produced when something is on fire. Some material burn with a flame and some do not. Okay, now here we will see the luminous flame and non-luminous flame. Luminous flame means a yellow flame that you can see here in the middle part, yellow flame which produced heat and applicable amount of light is called luminous flame. A luminous flame is obtained when a fuel undergoes partially, it means incompletely burn. Okay, so it is the luminous flame. Now second one is the non-luminous flame. Non-luminous flame means a blue colored flame. You can see here easily a blue colored, light blue colored flame which produce very little light is called non-luminous flame. And a non-luminous flame is obtained when the fuel is completely burned. Okay, now here you can see the different flame types emerge from a Bunsen burner. This is the yellowish, then orange, then purple, and it is light yellow. So different color from a Bunsen burner depending on the flow of air through the throat holes, that is hole on the sides of the Bunsen burner. Okay, now first one you can see this color is produced when the air holes completely closed. Whole air holes are completely closed, then a flame colors is like that. Now second one, the air holes are half open and half closed, so it is turned yellowish to this color. Now third one, air holes are nearly fully open. Only some holes are closed, so their color is like that. Now fourth one is all air holes are fully open and their color is lightish blue. Okay, so these are the different color from the Bunsen burner. Now here you can see that luminous part, which one is the luminous flame and which one is the non-luminous flame. First one is the non-luminous flame, because here is a yellowish, luminous flame, because it is a yellowish flame, and here the fuel is incomplete burn. Now here you can see a blue flame, colored flame, and here the fuel is completely burned. Okay, now we can see here the different zones of a flame. Okay, different zone of a candle flame. So you can see three zones of a candle flame. First one is outer zone. Okay, second one is the middle zone, and third one is the innermost zone. Outermost of zone is blue in color. Okay, here you can see lightest blue in this side. You can see the lightest blue color is the outermost zone, and it is the hottest part. You can see the outermost part is the hottest part of the flame. Okay, this is also the zone where complete combustion take place, so it is blue color, totally completely burned, so it is in blue color. Now second is the middle zone. Middle zone is a yellowish color. You can see here middle zone is yellowish color, and it is moderately heat. Okay, in this zone partially combustion take place. Okay, now third one is innermost zone of unburned wax, vaporized black. So innermost zone is black in color and least hot. It is the least hot part, and here we can find the unburned wax vapors of a candle. Okay, so there are the three zones of a candle flame. Now still you can see and heard about the goldsmith. Now here you can see the goldsmith blowing through a metallic pipe. Why do goldsmith blow at the outermost zone of a flame or for metallic gold and silver? Because the outermost zone of a flame is its hottest part. Right, you can see here already, you learn here the outermost zone is the hottest part. Right, hottest part is the outer zone. So outermost part of the flame is hot. Right, so gold and silver have a high melting point, and hence goldsmith blow at outermost zone of the flame to melt gold and silver. Okay, now here we will learn about the complete combustion and incomplete combustion. Complete combustion means the combustion in which the substance get completely burnt to form the highest oxide of the substance is called complete combustion. For example, you can see here the propane is burned with the oxygen, and it is totally burned and give here water. Now another example of the complete combustion is carbon. Suppose when we burn the carbon, it gives us complete combustion and it gives us carbon dioxide and heat and light also. So it is a complete combustion. Now second one is incomplete combustion. Incomplete means the fuel is not totally burned. So the complete combustion reaction that take place in the presence of insufficient quantity of oxygen is called incomplete combustion. For example, you can see the propane is burned with the oxygen and it is not totally burned. Here is the total 3 carbons are present and water is also present. Now another example, we can take the carbon again. So here is the carbon. When we burn with the oxygen, it gives us 2CO plus heat and light. Okay, so 2CO is not totally burned, so it is incomplete carbon monoxide. It is a carbon monoxide, and carbon monoxide is a deadly poisonous gas. Therefore, incomplete combustion is a waste of energy and hazardous. Okay, so here this topic is finished. We will meet into the next class. Okay.